Mum, are you there?
I've got a real bad headache.
Have you been put on sick call?
No.
Why not?
There's nothing wrong with her eyes. She's only after attention.
I think you can let me be the judge of that, Vera.
I'm not making it up, Doc. I got it real bad. It's just like my head was stuck in the press.
Can you remember when you started having these headaches, Doreen?
No.
Was it when you came back from the hospital?
I can't remember.
You better not be wasting our time, Anderson. Reception. It's for you.
Hello. Yes, Meg. Have you called an ambulance? All right, now listen. Is she having any trouble breathing? If you can, put her on the sofa and prop her up. It'll help. And tell Mum not to panic. It'll only restrict her breathing. I'll be right over. I'm sorry, Doreen. I'll have to see you tomorrow.
What's happened to Mum? That was our Mum you was talking about, wasn't it, Doc?
She's had a bad turn, I'm afraid. Oh. I'm sure she'll be all right.
What was Meg doing with her?
Was lucky she was. Excuse me, Vera.
I'm buying two. B?
What was that?
Two.
Oh, right. Hey, Eavesy, about time you said I think of yourself, isn't it? They'll probably put your trainer in a different cage after her trial.
I'll get off.
I can't see them letting their star witness disappear again.
She won't talk. And that's all they've got against me. I'd say this time in a couple of days, I'll be eating a lobster and sipping a scotch. I won't forget you, Martha. I can look after you from the outside.
Hey, Evie, why don't you ask your friend if she can pull some strings for you at your trial? You're gonna be up for the big one.
Reckon you could, Toni?
Give us a cigarette, huh?
How many you having, Lizzie? God, your face is long as a month of Sundays.
Do you reckon Dora'll be all right, B?
Oh, she's all right. Her nose is just out of joint because some people haven't got any idea of appreciation.
You was the one that put her nose out of joint.
Oh. At least I don't go around clobbering people half my size.
No, you just get a dronger to do it for you.
B, I wish you'd make it up with Dora. You know she's not quite right up top. She gets con real easy.
Yeah, well, I could name a few others like that.
What the doc say, love? You gonna need specs?
Mum's real crook.
Mum? Our mum?
How'd you find that out?
Mrs. Jackson rang the doc and they had to call an ambulance and everything.
God. Why'd something like that have to happen?
Don't
worry. Never heard a fly.
Anyone who can spend 12 years in here can survive anything. Hey, wait a bit. That means Mrs. Jackson must be still seeing Mum.
Yeah, and old Bennett knows about it too.
Oh, great.
Does that mean Mum's going to get in a strife?
Oh, no, but it means that Mrs. Jackson could sure and hell cop it.
Bloody Bennett!
Who cares? All screws are alike.
And I thought you knew it all, McNally. Oh, calm down, Martha. Listen, Doreen, how about making it up? You can't sulk forever.
You shouldn't have hit me so hard, Bee.
And you shouldn't have been so stupid. Oh, good, Doreen, when are you going to realise that some people are just out to use you and others just want to help you?
Well, from now on, I'm not going to believe anything from anybody. So there.
Oh, God, what's the use?
It's pethidine. It'll take the pain away.
Whatever's keeping them?
They'll be here as soon as they can.
What do you think it is?
Looks like acute pleurisy.
Is that serious?
Could be, especially at her age.
Judy. Shall I ring her, Mum?
I don't want to worry her.
Well, I'll wait here till she gets home, all right?
Thank you. if anything happens to me.
You're going to be fine, Mum.
Judy must go back to her parents. She's due in about a week.
Yes, yes, I know.
I'll be a great-grandmother. I want to see him. You know, I just have this feeling he's going to be a boy. I wasn't around when Judy was growing up. I thought I'd get a second chance with my great-grandchild.
Vera was in reception when you phoned. She knows you're here. Knowing her, she's probably put a report in already.
Oh, well, someone had to find out sooner or later. Thank heavens.
I'll go with her.
She's got to be all right, Greg.
Morning, Noel. Oh, morning, here.
Hello.
Let me.
Oh, thank you.
Been burning the midnight oil again?
I want everything up to date before the new governor arrives.
You've changed your mind about coming back?
I haven't decided either way yet, but I think it's best to assume I won't be back. Morning, Vera.
Morning, Vera. Morning. I thought you'd want to know. Mum was taken to hospital last night.
Oh, dear. What's the matter with her?
Well, if you ask Dr. Miller when he comes in, I'm sure he'll be able to tell you.
Yes, I will, Vera. Thank you.
Good. You better send a copy of this to the committee, along with those other notes that we drafted.
Right.
But please, don't ask them for their opinion. I don't want them trying to run the show.
I'll just send a covering note saying, for your records and interest.
You're learning. You know, I don't think I could have got this off the ground without your help, Karen. I would say that the halfway house is off to a flying start. Apart from a few minor setbacks, which I'm not going to mention.
Oh.
Can I get you a cup of coffee?
I could use one, thanks.
The surgery keeping you busy?
I've just come from the hospital. Mum was admitted yesterday, pleurisy.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Karen and Mum were at Wentworth together. Everyone used to call her Mum. That'll give you some idea of the sort of lady she is. She's been ill for some time. I'd asked Karen if she'd take care of her. Thought it might help. But it seems Karen was too busy.
I had no idea she was that ill. Will she be all right?
We'll know today.
I'll get some coffee.
Oh, I had no idea. I thought you were just saying it to get me away from here. I swear I didn't know.
It's just as much my fault. And you're right. My main reason was to get you away from Angela. I've had a lot of time to think lately, and when I had it all up, it seems to come out jealousy. And you don't feel that unless you care very much about someone, do you?
Greg, don't.
No, I'm not asking for anything. I'm just explaining.
Yes, all right. I think I know what you mean, but I can't just bounce back as if nothing ever happened to me. It did. I need time to adjust without pressure from you or anyone else. I need time by myself. Can you understand that? What about Meg Jackson?
I think she knows me better than I know myself. I don't want to hurt her.
I want all tools from the workshop checked in during every break. There's no need to stop what you're doing. Do you have any complaints about the machinery in here?
No, but I got a few about the so-called workers in here.
Let me know within the next couple of days whether we need to requisition parts or more up-to-date equipment. I'll see what I can do.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, we heard about Mum being off colour. You know how she is?
The grapevine certainly moves fast. No, I haven't heard yet.
Well, some of us thought we'd like to chip in out of our pay and maybe send her some flowers.
Well, let me have the names and the amount you want to spend.
It's real beaut you're letting us do something for Mum, Mrs. Davidson.
How are you feeling now, Doreen?
Oh, okay.
I think we better order some more sheets. These are getting a bit thin.
Mrs. Davidson, I was wondering if I could be shifted out of the laundry.
I've already suggested that to you, Doreen.
Yeah, but, you know.
Well, report to Cook. I'm sure she can find something for you to do.
Oh, thanks.
You wanted to work in the laundry, McNally? I suggest you do some. You can take over from Doreen.
What did I tell you? All screws are alike.
Hey, Bee, what do you reckon's going on? I mean, the governor hasn't had an inspection like this since God knows when.
Search me. She's probably expecting a visit from a VIP. Yeah, tell you what, I don't reckon old Vera's lagged on Mrs. Jackson.
Oh, even if she has, the governor wouldn't be too hard on her. I mean, she and Mum were always great friends.
Oh, I don't know, Lizzie. Mum's still an ex-crim. And rules are rules.
The most difficult thing is finding a suitable house manager. It'd have to be someone who understands the women's problems, but she'd also have to be a good administrator.
I take it once it's running smoothly, you won't be as heavily involved.
Well, I'll remain on as director, and I'll be on call. But I still have my law firm to answer to. And the house manager is a full-time position.
Look, I must be getting back to Wentworth. Thanks for the coffee.
Oh, look, any time.
Goodbye, Karen.
Bye. I'll see you at the next committee meeting, huh?
Fine. I'll see myself out. Bye-bye.
Angela?
Mm-hmm.
I could manage the house. I know I could handle it.
Well, as a matter of fact, I've had you in mind. But I don't think it's a very good idea.
Why?
Well, it has to be someone who understands the women's problems. You understand the women's problems, but you also have to care. Why didn't you tell me about this Mum person?
Well, I didn't think it had anything to do with you.
Well, it has a lot to do with what I don't want in the person running the halfway house.
That's not fair.
Isn't it? She's an ex-prisoner. She needed your help. You're in a position to help, and you didn't even try.
I'm not supposed to consort with an ex-prisoner. It's against the conditions of my parole.
Well, you could have got permission, but you didn't even try. Look, all you've proven to me so far is that you're irresponsible and insensitive. Karen, you're going to have to pull yourself together. Otherwise, you're just going to be like you were when you first came out of Wentworth.
Well, maybe that's where I belong.
Oh, don't pull that self-pity stuff with me. People can only help you 50% of the way. You are going to have to cope with that other 50%. Otherwise, you're no good to yourself or anybody else. You want to be trusted? Then you damn well earn it.
These can go into storage. They're over 4 years old.
Do you really think Mrs. Davidson will go ahead with her resignation?
I can't see why she'd want to change her mind.
Oh, well, I think it's a shame. She's beaut.
There are plenty who could run this place just as well, if not better.
They'd probably be bitches to work for.
These can go in too.
Wait here. She wants to see McNally.
Tell Mrs. Davidson she wants to vet all McNally's visitors.
Right.
You'll have to be searched. Put your bag there and go behind the screen.
Why?
Governor's orders. And if you want to visit McNally, you better do as you're told.
Bennett. Look, Vera, about Meg being at Mum's place.
She knows she's not supposed to see ex-prisoners. It was a stupid thing to do.
It's not too late. I'd be grateful if you didn't say anything to Erica.
How I do my job is my business.
Oh, come off it, Vera. She's been a pretty good friend to you.
You don't give me much credit, do you?
Does everybody have to go through this?
Just McNally's visitors.
You must think she's rather dangerous.
We have our reasons.
And you say you are related to Antonia McNally?
I'm her niece.
You haven't visited her before.
No, well, I've been away at boarding school. We've just broken up for the holidays.
Are your parents in Melbourne?
Yes.
Do they know you're here?
Aunt Antonia and my mother were very close. Do you think she killed that woman?
I am not in a position to judge that.
Well, then why all these questions and everything?
It's just a matter of security.
When's her trial?
I think you had better ask her that. Would you mind waiting outside for a moment? Do you believe her?
I can't place a girl like that with McNally, if that's what you mean.
Yes.
But she didn't bring any contraband in.
Very well. Keep an eye on things. I don't want any messages going out either.
We thought it was about time for your cuppa, Mrs. Davidson.
Thank you, Doreen. I could do with a cup of tea.
Cook made these this morning. They're real yummy. She let me try one.
She's certainly given me plenty.
Yeah, well, I kind of nicked a few more for you.
Well, I wouldn't want to hurt Cook's feelings. Perhaps you could help me out.
Oh, gee, thanks, Mrs. Davidson. You know, you're the nicest governor this place could ever have. Everyone reckons that. Even Bee thinks you're okay. Want to know why?
Pardon?
Because you're real nice to us. Even when you're being tough, you only do that because you have to. And you don't talk down to us, not like that old Miss Bennett.
Excuse me, Doreen, but I do have some work to do.
I'll wait for the tray if you like.
You can get it later.
I don't mind, honest.
Later, Doreen.
Okay, Mrs. Davidson. Oh, thanks for the cake.
Hello.
My name's Roslyn. I lied about the surname so I could get in to see you, but it's Coulson. Does that ring a bell? We've never met, but I think you knew my mother. She was the woman you murdered.
Get me out of here.
Don't you want to hear what I've got to say?
Listen, love. Why would I want to kill your mother? I didn't even know her.
I've got proof you did.
Come on, McNally. What proof? If you're staying, sit down.
My mother rang me about a week before you killed her. She said she was afraid. She said she was coming up to Sydney to get away from you.
Why would she want to say that?
Because she was seeing a man called Sean McNally. Your husband? And that's why you murdered her, isn't it? Jealousy.
Did she ever write to you about that?
No, but that's what she meant when she phoned me. She was scared of you.
You know what hearsay means? Wouldn't stand up in court for 2 seconds, love.
I'm going to the police. They'll believe me.
What a bit? I've heard enough. Sorry about your mother, love.
You murderer.
Come on, McNally, move.
Excuse me. Is that true? It's not enough proof?
You'll have to ask the police that. It was a silly thing to do, coming here.
I wanted to see what she looked like. I know she's guilty. She's got to be punished.
I'll send an officer to show you back to reception.
Those showers could do with an overhaul. You better organize a plumber, Mrs. Barry.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
And the recreation room is a mess. Those women will have to keep it in better order.
Right.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, I thought this might make your office look good.
Aren't you supposed to be in the kitchen, Doreen?
Oh, yeah, but Cook wanted some veggies from the garden.
Well, not now. I'm too busy.
I can put it in your office for you
if you like.
Wait
until later.
I wouldn't pinch nothing.
Oh, Dr. Miller, Miss Bennett told me about Mum. Have you had any further news?
Well, her condition's stabilised, which is a promising sign.
Oh, that's good.
I knew you wouldn't take Miss Bennett's side.
What are you talking about?
Well, Miss Bennett telling you about Mrs. Jackson being at Mum's. We reckoned you wouldn't be hard on her or anything.
Mrs. Barry, ask Mrs. Jackson and Miss Bennett to come to my office. I would like to see you also, Doctor.
Not only have you seen fit to involve yourselves in a game of subterfuge, but I also find the entire prison knows. I will not be made a laughingstock by the senior members of my staff. I haven't much longer before my resignation takes effect, but until that time, I am still the governor. If I cannot rely on my staff to follow the rules, then I've just been wasting my time. You could quite easily be dismissed, Mrs. Jackson.
She was very ill. I only wanted to see she was all right.
You don't expect me to believe this was the first and only visit, do you?
No.
And as for you, Miss Bennett, you're always so concerned about regulations. Why didn't you report this immediately? Or were you deliberately setting out to undermine my authority?
I didn't think it was that important.
I'm disappointed in all of you. You may go.
Could I have a word with you, Mrs. Davidson? An observation, that's all, but in my opinion, I think you ought to slow down a bit.
I do not need your advice about my health, Dr. Miller, and certainly not my work.
Oh, sorry, Mrs. Davidson, I thought you was alone.
What do you mean by bursting in here like that without knocking? Where do you think you are?
Oh, yeah, but you forgot this.
Oh, just put it down there and go.
I didn't mean to upset you, Mrs. Davidson. I never meant to get anyone in strife. I wouldn't hurt you or nothing.
You can go, Doreen. And I appreciate the thought.
It's okay, Mrs. Davidson.
You realize she's transferring her affections to you?
I am not encouraging her, Dr. Miller, but what can I do?
Put a stop to it before it gets out of hand. Don't let it become attached. And I would think about easing up a bit.
I'm sorry to have got you into it, Vera, but thanks anyway.
She better not report me, that's all. She's sick.
She's just been working too hard.
If she can't handle the strain, then the sooner she gets out, the better.
Who told you to do this?
Mrs. Barry. The governor wants this place shining from top to bottom. Hey, what's going on, Vera?
None of your business, Smith. When you're given something to do, you do it. Without your lackeys. Ooh. Well, you'd better do that again, McNally.
Who cares?
I would if I were you after what happened this morning. If there's one person who thought she'd got something on you, there could be others. And their evidence may not be hearsay.
I didn't know when you were coming down, but I haven't touched anything. I thought you'd want to pack her things yourself. We all miss her, love. You have quite a bit of money coming to you. Not that that's much comfort.
I know that McNally woman killed her, Pearl. I went to the police. But they said they'd never get her convicted on just my evidence.
Now, you stay right out of it, Roz. That woman's got too much pull.
But you think she murdered Mum too, don't you?
I think no such thing, love. I don't know anything about it.
Do you think she'll get off?
I don't know, love. Now, I'll let you settle in. You're welcome to stay as long as you like. But I don't want you anywhere near the main room or the girls. Oh, Jackie would have been so proud of you. She always wanted you to be a lady.
I won't keep you long. I'm sure there are other ways you would prefer to spend your spare time rather than listening to me.
Yeah.
As of tomorrow, I am taking leave. During my absence, the acting governor will be Mr. Fletcher, with Miss Bennett as acting deputy governor. I expect you all to be as cooperative with them as you have been with me.
Yeah. God's truth!
They're bound to try out the boat again.
We'll just have to see they don't get the chance.
Keep it down, Birdsworth.
Oh, never leave me.
Come on, Lizzie.
Why do you beat me?
Shh.
How long is Mrs. Davidson going to be away for, Mrs. Jackson?
About a month, Doreen.
Oh.
Come on, Dor. It's not the end of the world.
Oh, leave me
Oh, pity they didn't put you in the driver's seat, eh, Vera?
Mr. Fletcher's more than competent in taking over, Smith. I'm sure he'll see there are a few changes for the better around here.
You mean he might be giving you the boot?
Come in. Oh, Mr. Fletcher, I hope you didn't mind cutting short your holiday.
Oh, not at all. I'm looking forward to getting back into it.
I've tried to keep things up to date, but if I have forgotten anything, I'm sure Miss Bennett and Mrs. Jackson will be able to give you a hand.
Right.
These are the women about to be released or up before the parole board. I've made a few suggestions on their files. Oh, and Doreen Anderson. If we're not careful, she could have another breakdown. Dr. Miller's keeping an eye on her, and if necessary, she may have psychiatric help. I don't want to stop her parole, but unless she improves, I can see no other alternative. Yes?
Oh, welcome back, Mr. Fletcher.
Thank you, Miss Bennett.
I've written out a few suggestions for improvements and general maintenance, if you wouldn't mind following them through.
Well, I'm sure Miss Bennett and I will make sure that things run smoothly.
Yes. Well, I don't think there's anything else. Goodbye and good luck.
Mrs. Davidson.
Goodbye, Miss Bennett.
Mrs. Davidson. Well, you're looking very well. Your holiday must have agreed with you.
Yeah, it was good to be with the kids again.
Well, I'm glad you're back. You've no idea what it's been like here the last few weeks.
Well, we'll soon put things back on the right track, eh?
Have you got any plans?
Not one. For the first week, I'm going to do absolutely nothing. After that, I might go away for a while.
We'll have a wonderful time. But think about taking back your resignation, won't you?
You have my number if I've forgotten anything.
Is McNally ready? Her barrister's waiting for her.
I'll let Mr. Fletcher know.
I won't keep you, Meg. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Take care.
I'll take this to the car, Mrs. Davidson.
Mrs. Davidson!
Look, you know you're not supposed to come in here without permission.
I just want to say goodbye.
I don't want to hear that you've been getting into any trouble while I'm away, Doreen.
I wish you wasn't going.
Well, Mr. Fletcher will be here to help you.
I hate him. You're the only one who understands.
Come on, Doreen.
Goodbye.
Smith's out of solitary. Ferguson got her parole. At least that's one less troublemaker. But as for McNally, well, she thought she was running the place and Mrs. Davidson let her get away with it, which made my job all the more difficult.
Well, I'm sure our little idea will make things run a lot smoother.
Yes, I don't know why it hasn't been tried before. Mm. Jim, did you and your wife get on all right?
Well, you know, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Could you come over and have dinner one night?
Yeah, sure, but let me settle in for a few days first, eh?
McNally's barrister's here. She's appearing in court this morning.
Ah, well, could you see to it, please, Miss Bennett? I'd like a word with Mrs. Jackson.
Of course.
Miss Bennett told me there's been a bit of trouble lately.
No more than usual.
Well, we have a few ideas we'd like to put into action straight away.
Well, that's fast work.
I'm sorry, I don't follow you.
Mrs. Davidson's hardly out of the building, and you're already making changes.
Well, I don't believe in wasting time, Mrs. Jackson. And I'm going to need the cooperation of all my staff.
Maybe he won't be feeling such a bastard after his holes.
Oh, come off it, Phil. Fletcher's like Vera. Once a rat, always a rat.
So what are we going to do about it? He's top dog now.
You reckon? No, we'll just hang about. Let them make the first move, then we'll take it from there.
Oh, good to see you back, Dor.
I've got nowhere else to go now.
Oh, you got friends in here, Dor? I mean, the old gov's all right, but she's still one of them.
Oh, what would you know about it, Lizzie?
Come on, McNally. It's time.
Hey, Fletch been game up for shop yet?
Mr. Fletcher, Smith.
He's arrived.
Well, if I don't see you all again, it'll be too soon.
Yeah, yeah, I've heard it all before. Mainly from people who usually end up getting life.
See you, Toni.
Keep my place warm. In case.
Well, I hope she doesn't get off.
Serves you right, Eavesy, for picking the wrong team. Nah, anyway, good luck to her. Anyone who plays around with another woman's husband deserves to get bumped off.
You mean she really did do it?
Oh, what do you think?
Jeez. But in your statement to the police, you gave a very clear description and also identified Antonia McNally as the assailant.
I must have been confused. I was in shock.
Miss Buchanan, you claimed you came out of a cubicle on hearing a shot. saw the deceased, Mrs. Jackie Coulson, lying on the floor and a woman putting a gun in her handbag.
Yes, but I didn't really see who did it. I mean, I'm a bit short-sighted and all I saw was the back of a woman's head. She was leaving just as I came out.
Silence! Miss Buchanan, I must remind you that you're under oath.
Yes, sir. But I'm sorry. I didn't see who killed her. I don't know. Honestly.
All right, Miss Buchanan, we step down.
Talks at the arbitration court broke down when union leaders continued to hold out for a further $5 a week pay rise. In the Supreme Court today, Mrs. Sean McNally appeared on charges of murdering Mrs. Jackie Coulson earlier this year. The defendant's lawyer stated that he anticipates a brief trial resulting in the clearing of his client.
Hello, Nancy. Erica. I'm fine. I've actually taken a few weeks' holiday. I was wondering if you and John could come over for dinner one night this week. Oh, are you? No, I'd forgotten about school holidays. How are they, by the way? Oh, good. You must be very proud of them. Oh, really? I see. How sweet.
Okay, Phil, how much are you coughing up?
Put me down for a dollar.
Edie and me did these just a few weeks ago. I know what it's like to keep losing friends, Dor. Everyone needs someone to look up to. Don't suppose I can expect you to look up to an old woman like me. But we've been together too long to let B and Toni split us up. And B didn't mean to hit you so hard. Oh, don't suppose I can expect you to like an old good-for-nothing like me.
I don't reckon you're an old good-for-nothing, Lizzie.
Does that mean we're mates again?
Of course we are. She's the only friend I got in here.
You can help clean up in here, McNally.
Taking longer than you thought, eh?
But it is going like a dream.
All right, girls. Let's give the new governor a little clap.
Oh, you look real nice out of uniform, Mr. Fletcher.
I'm only going to say this once, so pay attention. Tonight, you'll pack all your things. Tomorrow, you'll be ready to move into different cells with different cellmates. We'll tell you who you're going to move in with tomorrow, and we'll keep you moving every so often just to break up your little gangs. That's all.
Bloody mongrel.
Filthy mongrel trick that'd be.
He can't do that, Mrs. Jackson. Some of the girls have made those rooms their homes. I don't want to move with anyone else. I've been with Doreen for years now.
You'll get used to it, Birdsworth.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
What was that, Smith?
Nothing, Miss Bennett.
These are the ones that want to send flowers to Mum. $15 worth, it okay?
Mr. Fletcher won't allow it.
Mrs. Davidson said that we could.
Mrs. Davidson isn't here anymore.
May I have a word with you, Miss Bennett?
You tell her, Mrs. Jackson!
Yeah. Right. Well, that does it.
Now, that's going too far, Vera, isn't it? Especially after Mrs. Davidson said they could.
We're showing them right from the start that we're going to run this place the way it should be run, like a prison.
And what about Lizzie and Doreen? They're harmless. And the worst thing that could happen to Doreen at the moment would be to be thrown in with a total stranger.
She's a prisoner like the rest of them.
Oh, use your head for once, Vera, and stop being so power conscious.
Mrs. Davidson mightn't have reported that little episode with Mum, but I'm sure Mr. Fletcher would. It's not too late, you know.
Don't threaten me, Vera.
I'm reminding you that you're an officer and you should act like one. Or are you more on the side of the inmates these days?
At least some of them act like human beings.
If we let them get the upper hand on this one, there'll be no stopping them.
Had pictures up on my walls for 2 years. If I take them down now, they'll rip.
Yeah, you two ought to get in on this. After all, you're supposed to be the brains on the outside.
What's the big deal? All those cells look alike anyway.
I've been in that cell for over 10 years. It's not the same. It's mine.
Yeah.
I just don't want to get myself involved in anything that could end in a riot, that's all.
Don't you want to help us, Toni?
I'm not jeopardizing my chances of getting out of here.
Comes the crunch and you turn your back on us.
I've got my own problems. You want to be in it? Go ahead.
What do you want me to do, B?
Hang on a tick. You with us, Doreen?
If Mrs. Davidson was here, she wouldn't let this happen.
And you reckon I'm going to? Look, let me tell you something. I've been here a long time, probably longer than the rest of you. Okay, it was my choice. I knew what I was doing, and I knew I'd end up back on the inside. So this is my home, right? And I'm gonna keep it in order. I clobbered you because the minute my back was turned, you got into drugs.
It was only a couple of funny cigarettes.
Yeah, well, that's how my kids started. First a couple of smokes, then into snipping stuff, and then into the really hard stuff. No one, especially a kid like you, is going to get hooked on anything except being released, not while I'm around. Look, you lot may not be much, but you're all the family I got now.
What do you want me to do, B?
Listen, we're going to need some stuff in the laundry. You reckon you and Lizzie can manage that?
Oh, me and Lizzie can nick anything that's not nailed down, can't we, Lizzie?
And even that's never stopped us.
Right, well, let's show Bennett and Fletch who's really taken over Wentworth.
Yeah. I feel so awful about dropping in and talking about work.
I would have told you if I minded when you phoned.
Yes, but on your first day off, when you're supposed to be having a wonderful time.
I am. I could get used to this quite quickly.
Oh, you'd soon get bored.
I just wish so many of my friends weren't away at the moment. Most of them have families and are heading off for the school holidays. But I'm sure I'll find plenty to keep me busy. And if I get bored, I can always get more involved in the halfway house.
Oh, I didn't think you were very impressed after that last meeting.
Angela Jeffries phoned. She can be very persuasive. What does Dr. Miller think about the situation at the prison?
I haven't discussed it with him.
Oh. I wouldn't worry too much at this stage, Meg. They're both good at their jobs, and the department wouldn't have put Mr. Fletcher into the position if they hadn't thought he was suitable.
Oh, they'll follow the rules all right. Without feeling and lots of discipline.
Perhaps that's where I went wrong. Too soft.
Rubbish. You were trying to help, and you did.
Well, there are other ways, and regimentation isn't all that bad.
I know what it did to my mother, taking me away from her the minute I was a year old.
Yes. It's still a prison ruling, unfortunately. But the system has changed since those days, Meg, in other areas.
Yes. And Vera and Mr. Fletcher are going to set it back right where it was 30-odd years ago.
Well, we'll just have to wait and see.
Come on, you two, get a move on. Birdsworth, you'll be moving in with Gaffney. Anderson, you're in with Higgins and Dwyer. What's this? The silent treatment. No one got any objections? Where are your personal things?
There you go, Miss Bennett. I'm an old woman. This is enough for one trip.
Smith, you move in with Barton. And you're switching places with Armstrong. If you think that not speaking is going to wear us down, Smith, you're very much mistaken. I could think of nothing better than never hearing your voice again.
Come along, you lot.
Once this lot's settled, I'll check the other wing.
Right. Well, I'd say we're in for a pretty quiet time, wouldn't you, Miss Bennett?
Now!
Hey! What do you think you're playing at, Smith?
I'm not
playing, Fletch. I think it's time we had a little chat.
Open that gate immediately.
You're in no position to give orders, Vera. And if you don't listen to us for a change, this lock goes up in smoke.
And you whip it.
We can get out through the other wings. But how are you going to explain a fire on your second day as governor? I don't reckon that'll go down too well at all, do you? I don't reckon we're asking too much, Fletch. Look at it this way. How'd you like to be thrown out of your home?
You're not on the outside now, Smith, in case you'd forgotten.
I reckon we know where we are right enough.
We want Mrs. Davidson back.
Oh, shut up.
You've got nothing to bargain with, Smith. Now open this door before we open it for you.
No way, Fletch.
Miss Knox, Miss Bennett.
Don't be stupid, Bean. This isn't going to help any of you.
You don't think I'd be enough of a fool to overlook a little thing like that, do you, Fletch? There's not one that works in the whole prison. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. Talking about moving house, I think.
All right, you can stay in your cells.
I've only got your word for that.
When I give my word, I keep it.
Uh-uh. Someone else gave me her word once and I ended up in the pound for 2 weeks. I'm sure you two remember that little incident.
That was a mistake. Now, I'm speaking for all the officers now. There'll be no solitary, no change of cells.
That covers all of us?
Yes.
Okay. Catch, Vera.
Good on you, Vera.
I can't remember when I last went to a ball, let alone the Lord Mayor's. Word certainly travels fast. No, I haven't decided yet. I have a month to make up my mind. So, if I can help with the arrangement, Sylvia, good. I'd enjoy it. Oh, no. The way I feel at the moment, I could tell them I've thought it over and my resignation still stands.
Now, what's he want to see us for, anyway? He's going to give us time off for good behaviour.
He's not backing out, is he?
I'm sure Mr. Fletcher's a man of his word, Doreen. Ugh. In you go.
God! What's happened?
Oh, no!
Oh, where's it all gone to?
Quiet.
This room stays this way until you've learnt to behave yourselves. All damage to prison property will be taken out of your wages.
You will all be put on report, which no doubt will come into consideration when any of you are up before the parole board.
As of now, you're going to learn to do what you've been told.
You bastard.
You can forget the buy-up for this week for that little remark, Smith.
And the work bell will go in 5 minutes.
What are we going to do, B?
No, I'll tell you one thing. They haven't heard the last of this.
There's no rotten justice, inside or out. Bloody mongrels.
Oh, yes, there is. And we're going to show them what it means.
Mr. Foreman and members of the jury, have you agreed on your verdict?
We have.
How say you? Do you find the prisoner guilty or not guilty of murder in the first degree?
Not guilty.
How say you? Do you find the prisoner guilty or not guilty of murder in the second degree?
Not guilty.
Hearken to your verdict as the court records it. You find the prisoner not guilty of murder in the first or second degree. That is the verdict of you all.
It is.
Oh, that feels good. You did all right, Terry.
Thank you.
I'll make sure you get an extra good bonus for that one.
Did I do okay?
You can sleep peacefully from now on, love. Sure.
I want you packed and out of my house by tonight.
What?
And if you think you're coming back into the business, I promise you you're going to have one hell of a fight on your hands. You're finished, Toni.
Not on your life, sweetheart. I put too much into that business to get kicked out now. While you were busy playing around with that slut, I was working my guts out. Can you hear me? You're past it, sure. It's only sluts like Coulson will have anything to do with you.